Alright. This is your crash course to medical. You've spawned into the station and you're a doctor. And you're hanging out here in the med bay and you're wondering what to do. First thing you do is to get your stuff. So you go over to one of these lockers. You want to make sure to grab a pair of these gloves. They go on your hands. They let you firemen carry people quicker, and they keep nasty dead body juice off of you so you don't get sick. You'll usually want a medical belt. This will fit a bunch of medical stuff in there, like your surgery tools that you start with here, which are always very useful to have on hand in a pinch, especially if you're trying to tend wounds to somebody, you know, in a hurry. And the last thing you'll want is this health scanner hood. Put that on your eye slot, and that gives you this little bar above people. If it has a face on it, like if it's blue or green or yellow or red and gray and flashing, that means they have some kind of a disease. Red and gray and flashing, you should probably be panicking. Red's really bad. Orange is very bad. And green, like flat face, is something that could be bad. And green frowny face is definitely bad. Blue happy face? That's good. That usually means they have some kind of a positive trait. Or more often than not, they just don't have any symptoms at all. So just keep your eye out for that. If it has a weird little egg that's like purple here in this symbol, that means they have a xenomorph in their chest. You're going to want to take that out. Let's see. What else? If it's flashing, it means they're in crit. If it's a little wavy line, that means that they are dead, but their soul is still there. If it is just a skull here, that means they're dead and they have DNR'd, so you can still bring them back to life, but they're not playing that character anymore. They've either ghosted or gone to play some other like ghost role, or they've logged off from the server. So you see the skull, put them in a bag. If you see the wavy line, do what you can to revive them. Anyway, let's see here. Get medical set up. You're going to want to grab these defibs. You want to bring them over here. There's going to be at least 2 lifeform stasis units on your station, and you're going to want to put those defib units in these wall mounts here. If you need to defib somebody, just click on it. That shows up in your hand. Click on it again. Zip zap, you can defib somebody. You drop it and it just goes back into the container there. So don't worry about that. On an ice box, you got one more down here, which is useful to have because they got like a operating mini theater out here. Next thing you'll want to do is set up cryo. And to do that, you're going to want to grab your medical wrench. Don't let anybody take your medical wrench from you. It is your birthright. You're going to want to wrench both of these down. Just click on them once. Grab 2 bottles of this stuff. Jam it in there. Just click on them. And you're going to want to click on that. Set it all the way down as low as it'll go and turn that on. And that's cryo setup. If somebody has a lot of respiratory or toxin damage and you need them to be not dying, you can chuck them in there. You can make pyroxidone pretty easily by ordering a dead jelly person, drawing their blood, and then mixing that with the leftover cryo juice. That's a little more advanced. That's some chemistry stuff. Speaking of chemistry stuff, I will show you how to set up some very basic advanced healing meds real quick. This is what I do basically every shift when I start up. So you grab the big beaker, and you're just going to do this. You're going to pull up the chem dispenser and set it to plus 10. Do welding fuel, carbon, hydrogen. That gets you 30 units of oil. You're going to hit minus 20 on that so that you have 10 units left. and then you're going to add 10 chlorine, 10 water. That nets you 30 units of phenol. Now, phenol is the precursor to both oxandrolone, which is a very good burn med, and salicylic acid, which is a very good brute healing med. So, first we're going to make the oxandrolone. We're going to hit 30. We're going to add 30 units of carbon. And then we're going to hit 10 units of oxygen, 10 units of hydrogen. That'll get us 60 units of oxandrolone. Now there's going to be 20 units of phenol left. You want to leave that in there. Because you're going to come over to the chem master here, you're going to pop that in. You're going to move this, you're going to hit all on the oxandrolone to move it to this buffer here. That's going to stay in the machine. Everything up here is going to stay in the beaker. So you inject it, you've got just your phenol in here. I'm going to put that back in here. I'm going to switch this to 20. There's going to be wizards. You're going to ignore those. And then you're going to hit carbon, oxygen, sodium, and sulfuric. And that'll get you 100 units of salicylic acid. You're going to let that bubble until it's done. In the meantime, you're going to pop over here. Pop this open. You're going to open up this box of gels. Because these hold exactly 60 units. I like to turn it orange. I'll click on it and it'll bring up a little wheel and you can pick the color that you want. And you just move that all to your spray bottle and you got that now. You shove that on your belt. So now you got burn meds. One spray. You want to do one spray, you want to avoid doing two. If you do more than two, then you're going to overdose them and they're going to die. Probably. Anyway, for the acid, set it all over there. We're going to do 7 patches. Patches are better than pills in general because you don't have to wait for it to process through their stomach, and you can apply it to people that have masks on or even spacesuits on. So you don't have to take that stuff off to put it on or inject it. So patches, create 7. That's about 14 units each. We're going to walk over here. We're going to grab our box of pill bottles from this pile of crap. We're going to reach in there. Pill bottle. This conveniently holds exactly 7 items, 7 pills or 7 patches. We pick all those up by clicking on them. We click them on over into our belt here. And voila, we have brain, come on. Don't do it to me now. We have 60 units of burn meds, and we have 100 total units of brute meds. So if anybody's hurt, like this person, so limping their way toward me, they've dislocated something, I'm sure. Yep. If you ever see somebody moving like that, yeah. So normally what you'll do is you'll go and get the bone setter from the surgery room and just use it on that leg. If you don't have access to a bone setter, you can do it this way. So you target their right leg. You make sure you're not on combat, you're on help. So this isn't highlighted. You grab them once, you grab them again, and then you click on them. And that will start trying to set their leg. It might take a few tries. And it will hurt them a lot. So once that's done, grab your suture. They will complain. And you just suture them up. And then they're good to go. And you spin in celebration. Ow. Well, I've been shot, so what we're gonna wanna do is determine where we've been shot. Left arm. So we're gonna check our health analyzer. We're not bleeding, but that has basically disabled our left arm, so we're going to probably grab that and give ourselves a patch, and then do the same thing to this person. There we go. Now, that'll heal itself by itself. For salicylic acid and oxandrolone, they work similarly. they will heal faster if the person's above 25 damage. So want to kind of reserve it for that. It'll heal regardless, but yeah. Anyway, getting back to the health scanner. If we direct our attention over this area, this will tell you their overall health status. It'll tell you if they have any disabilities. So if you're like, they can't see and you're trying to heal them and the thing keeps saying they're blind, you want to check here just to see in case that they have in fact taken the blind trait, so that you're not trying to peel something that can't be fixed. And then it will also give you brain traumas in this area, a couple other things like if they're irradiated or not, so keep your eye on that part. This is just the damage stats, so they'll show you brute, burn, toxin, and suffocation. If all these numbers add up to 200, they're dead. If it's over 100, then they're going to be in a crit. If it's over, I think, 140 or 150, then they are into hard crit. They can't move around. They can't talk. They're going to start suffocating, and then they will die if they don't get helped. If they are in soft crit, they can kind of still move around and stuff, but they can't really interact, and they're really vulnerable to getting hurt even more. This will tell you their species, which is important for, say, if they're a jelly person, which means if they are a jelly person, you cannot give them toxin healing meds because toxin healing hurts them. If you really want to kill, if you really want to kill somebody really quick that's a jelly person, you just give them the pentanic acid injector. They will die really fast. So try not to do that. Give them the temperature, which is very useful in case you get a miner in and you're trying to fix them and they keep taking more burn damage, and then you'll realize that they're like 2,000 degrees, in which case you want to like take their clothes off, put them under a shower, that kind of thing. Or if they're really cold, you can go get them like a coffee to warm them up or set them on fire or something, whichever. And then you'll have the blood level keep. Very important to pay attention to the blood level and the blood type. If your person is suffocating and they keep dying and you don't know why, check the blood level. If it is below 75%, they will be taking suffocation damage. If it is above 75, they're going to be taking a little bit of suffocation damage, but not enough to actually kill them before their blood level will regenerate if they're being left alone. They're not still bleeding. So anything above 75 and they're not bleeding, they should be okay. Above 80, they'll be good to go regardless. Anything below 75, you're going to want to go and get a blood pack from the blood freezer down here. We're usually looking at a cold room and other stations here. And I might match up their blood type if they're not human. Blood type L, that's for lizards. LE is liquid electricity. That's for ethereals. You'll know it because it's green. Don't give the green blood to other people. Any other weird types? No, not really. Everything else is, you know, standard stuff. If you don't know what type of blood to give them and you're in a hurry, just grab O negative. You can give that to anybody. If they are a positive type, you can grab O positive. That can go to anybody with a positive type. Otherwise, you just want to match it up or use a blood chart. They think they got one on the wiki there still. Let's see. Piles. What else? Then the scanner. Right, so some basic medical information I should have covered at the beginning. Sutures heal brute. You target the body on the paper doll here by clicking on it, or you can use the number keys on your numpad, and that will, like, 8 is the head, 4 and 6 are the arms, 1 and 3 are the legs, 5 is the body. So you can select it that way if you want to, if you don't feel like fiddling around trying to click on this. Sorry, I'm yawning. And broke my mom. Okay. Right, so in order to heal stuff, like, if they've got, like, I had 50 damage to the left arm. If I wanted to just heal that without using a patch, just click on the left arm, and you click on the person, and it will attempt to use a suture on them. Once it is finished healing, it'll give you this message that they can't be healed anymore, and that will be done. These also work on bleeding. If somebody's bleeding, this also is good. It will start to do bleeding damage, a bleeding wound, before any brute damage. So if they're bleeding from that arm, that's going to do that first before it tries to heal any damage from that arm. It'll give you a different message in the chat here. These regenerative messages, these are for burns. They work the same way. If somebody has, like, second-degree burns, third-degree burns, and it's asking you for, like, regeneration chemicals in the wound text, this is the thing you want to use. You'll apply that onto there, and it'll give you a message once it's finished that, you know, the...
Sorry.
The message has been applied, and there's nothing else that you can do. Epinephrine. Epinephrine is really important. If you don't know anything else, if you take nothing else from this video, if you see somebody that's laying down and it says that they're unresponsive and appears to be asleep, and you want to help them, you stab them with this pen. Because if they're on the verge and they can get back up, it'll get them up. If they're going to die anyway, it puts formaldehyde in them, which will keep their organs from rotting, which means they're going to be on the table less time. Because you're not going to have to replace all their organs or fix them or do whatever. So, you see somebody hurting, you jab them with the EpiPen. Don't give them more than one. They will have an allergic reaction, probably make things worse. So, just one. Just one's fine. Bandages. Bandages are good for wounds. Especially bleeding ones. Bleeding wounds, it'll reduce the bleeding. Any other type of wound, like a burn or a broken bone, that kind of thing, sorry, it'll stabilize it. So that means it will keep it from getting worse for a while, so that if you need to move somebody, like say they have like a compound fracture in a leg, you wrap that up, it'll move it and it'll keep it from getting worse or doing more damage to them. Let's see. Health scanner has a couple of modes. So we'll show you that real quick. So if you click on it, it will report extra info on wounds. If you don't have any wounds, it won't show you anything. If, let's see. If you do have a wound, like say, you are wounded and you have, let's say, a cut, the normal health analyzer, there it is, let's see, you click on that, it'll tell you what type of wound it is. If you click on it like this for extra info, it'll tell you what type of wound it is and the recommended treatment. This is especially important for things like third-degree burns or catastrophic burns, because there is a point where you can't fix it normally anymore and you have to amputate or augment the part. So if somebody is dying from third-degree burns and they won't heal and they won't go away despite doing all the steps listed on the wiki to fix them, use this and it'll say, you know, recommended amputation or augmentation, and that means it's too far gone, in which case do those things. Also, the other very useful thing is if somebody is poisoned, if you right click on them with it, it will tell you the reagents in their blood and the reagents in their stomach. Which is very useful because that'll tell you what type of damage it's doing and if there's poison in it to begin with, which means, you know, apply antitoxin meds. You can go over to the contents of the medical hits real quick. So we've got four flavors. We've got Oxygen, Burn, Brute, and Toxin. We'll start with Oxygen. So we got Cover Maul. This will heal Oxygen damage at the cost of doing a little bit of Toxin damage over the threshold. It's pretty useful if they're taking a bit and you don't have this available, which is Salbutamol. You want to generally just want to use this first if it's like a really bad situation. If it's kind of manageable but they're just having a little trouble, you just give them some of the syringe. Just one injection is fine. One of this is also fine. You can't overdose anybody on Salbutamol, so you don't have to worry about that. You can overdose people on Condromol, so be careful of that. Normal EpiPen as well. And then you have your iron pills. Iron pills are for regenerating blood. So if somebody's kind of low, if they're like at 74%, something like that, and you don't have access to a blood pack, you can give them one of these and just kind of try to keep them alive. Maybe give them another dose of suffocation meds, and that'll kind of carry them over until their blood regens to the point where it won't matter anymore and they can breathe normally. Moving to the burn one. These are Ayuri patches. They are just basic burn med. Slap them on. You can't overdose people. It does do minor eye damage. So just want to make sure to be careful of that. These ones are diluted with... God, how do you pronounce that? I always fuck it up. Granibetaluri, whatever. I just call it Gran. It's an okay healing medicine. Just be careful because a lot of people end up getting allergic to it if they roll the allergic trait. So just make sure to double check that, because you'll be like, oh, I'm just going on this patch. That's not on their list, but it's still in there. It's sneaky. This thing. This is the Hercuri spray. You can use this on like humans, warm-blooded people, pretty easily. Don't give them more than one or two sprays. Don't use this on lizards unless you really know what you're doing, because this will cause them to freeze to death very easily. So be careful with that. Oxandrolone, that's the stuff that we have in our little bottle here. Jam that in there. It's really good against very severe burns. And then just another epinephrine. Put it in there. Ugh, sorry. Brute meds. Libitol, same thing as the Ayuri. With a little bit of liver damage. It's diluted with Gran. Ethimethylglucose. This is good for, like I said, it's for all kinds of wounds, but mostly bleeding and stuff. Probitol. This is useful for slightly more severe brute damage. You give them one of these pills, and ideally you have them eat something, because then that'll make a healing enzyme, and that'll make them heal faster. The disadvantage is that it gives them stamina damage, so it'll make them very slow and very tired. If you overdose them, it's going to make them fall asleep. And then we have the Salicylic Pen, which is the same stuff as these patches, and we've already been over that, so that's what's in there. Now we get to the really interesting one, which is the Toxin Meds. So, we'll start with our escalating severity here. We have Multivir here. This is basically charcoal. You just give them one of these. It'll do a little bit of lung damage if you give them too much, so don't overdo it. It's scales with other medicines in the system, like it says. So if you give them this and some other meds, like Libitol, the other stuff in there, it'll heal them a little bit faster for toxin damage. It also purges a little bit of the toxin from their system. This is the big one. That another thing that if you don't remember anything else, remember this. Only give them one dose of 5 units, so one injection of this at a time. Serenivir is very potent. It works with your liver to make Mucivir, which is the actual chemical that does the healing and the purging. If you give them too much, it will damage your liver very severely. and the more damage it has, the less well it works. So not only will the toxins be doing toxic damage to the liver, this medicine will also be doing toxic damage to the liver. So make sure to scan them before you use this. If their liver's in bad shape, don't use it. Use something else. Potassium iodide, that give them one of these if they're irradiated. It's mostly based on toxic damage. If somebody's irradiated, you just want to jab them with either one of these, the Serenivir or the Pent. Give them a potassium iodide pill, shove them under their shower until they stop glowing. That's irradiation. Pent, very, very potent purgative, and it also heals toxin damage. If somebody is dying from toxin and you don't know what's going on, jab them with this. It'll fix it 7 out of 10 times, probably. So, yeah. If nothing else, if you can't remember what to do with toxins in the heat of the moment, grab the green pen, stab them with the green pen. It'll usually fix it. Let's see. There are fun things in medical here. Surgery? Surgery could be its own video. I might actually do that because... Well, we'll do a really brief thing here. So, here's your surgical table. You got your surgical procedures on here. Let's do a dissection real quick just to show you how it works. Ba-da-ba-ba. Grab the person. Get them on the table. You grab them while they're laying down or standing up. And then you just click on the table. And it'll pop them on the table. Alright. So, let's say we want to... Let's say we want to take out this guy's appendix. You have had the orange frowny face pop up over somebody. They're puking everywhere. They probably have appendicitis. You scan them. It says appendix status inflamed, and it'll show the damage of the organ. So, in that case, you drag them over here. In this case, we're going to target the groin area, so it's right below the chest. You just click on there. First step, grab the surgical drapes. And then the second step is to choose the surgery that we want. It has to be unobstructive, so they have to have their clothes off, or you have to use the little ripper thing for the spacesuit that almost nobody ever uses, so you don't have to worry about that. Just have them take their clothes off. Organ manipulation, because they're going to be taking some out. And if you're new, you're not going to know the steps. The steps are the same every time, and it'll usually tell you what they are here. The first step's making an incision, that's the scalpel. And then we retract the skin, which is the retractor. And next we're gonna do the hemo to clamp the bleeders, do another incision, and then we reach in. We would grab the appendix there if they had an appendix. There's no appendix there. It would pop up a menu, and then you would select it, and it would remove that item from them, and then it just kind of appears underneath. And then once you're done, you can grab your cautery, seal it up, we're done. If you want to get something out of their chest, you would do the same thing. Organ manipulation is basically available on all ends. If you're trying to implant something like a tool set or something like that, that's for basically every limb. Same steps. Scalpel. Retractor. In this case, since it's the chest, this also goes for the head. There's a bone in the way, so we need a circular saw. We need that. Get through the old rib cage. It makes a horrible noise. It does a bunch of damage to them. Be mindful of that. If they're in really bad shape, if they're in like flash and crit, and you do this to them, they're going to die. So just be mindful of that. If they die, it's no big deal. They're already on the table. Just zap them once you're done. Clean the bleeders. Do the incision. Click on the person, not on the table. If you click on the table, it's just going to put your instrument on the table. Manipulate organs, hemostat. Alright, and then we want to take out this person's heart. And then we give her the old Yankee. And we close it up. We're done. You can do as many organs or as few organs as you want. You're putting stuff in. You don't have to use the hemostat. You can just insert the item after you do the scalpel step. That's the most basic surgeries that you're going to be doing. There's the other ones that are 10 wounds, which is just use the drapes, use a scalpel, use a hemostat until they're either healed enough to revive and use meds, or they're all better. In which case, you just zap them, give them CPR, and they'll be back up. Yeah, that's most of the basic stuff of medicine. No, I'm forgetting something. Right, the beds. Stasis beds. If somebody is dying, or you don't know what's going on, or they are already dead and you have room, throw them on the stasis bed. It will halt all their biological processes. This means that their organs don't rot. It also means that medicines, toxins, and blood loss does not happen. So as long as they're strapped to this, they won't bleed out, usually. Their toxins will stop progressing unless they have organ damage. I think that still progresses. So it stops basically everything with some caveats. And definitely if they're dead and you want to keep their organs from decaying without using formaldehyde, you definitely want to show them on there. Very useful, only usable if they're powered. You can also do surgery on them, but you'll have to know the steps by heart because there's no, or have them up on the wiki page, because there's no surgery computer. That also limits the amount of surgeries that you can do, because you can do all this extra stuff on actual surgical table because it has the computer attached to it. Up here, you can only do the basic ones that you start with. So yeah, you want to do that. If somebody's dying, if they're in crit, that kind of stuff. Let's see, what else? Right, so the crew monitoring console. We'll go over this real quick. Right, so the binary vitals is the most basic thing that you can have on there without it being off. It'll show you, are they alive or are they alivent? It'll switch to dead if they've died, and it will say alive if they're alive. Very useful. But you don't want that. You want them to have exact vitals or a tracking beacon. Exact vitals gives you this information here, which is all of their damage types, and there's like overall health status, and it also gives you their position if they have the tracking beacon on. This will show you a skull if they are dying. Usually the skull only shows up once they're into heart crit, which is over 150 damage if I remember right. Just make sure you see somebody on there that's in really bad shape, but they aren't at 200 damage total across all these here, that means they're not dead yet, so you can rush over and save them if you can. Otherwise, they're dead. Then brought in your paramedic, that's your deal. If you're a doctor and you don't have any paramedics, that's also your deal. If you have paramedics, just send them out. They have more access than you do, and just a better thing for them to do, because then you can chill out here and sip your drink, wait for the dead bodies to come to you, and then fix them. It's also useful if there's bad people and you want to know where they are. You can relay this just over the radio or to specific people. You'll have a lot of command staff pop in every now and then to look at this one here because it's closer than the one in the bridge or in security. The warden's office. Vending machines. Real quick. Nano drugs have some good stuff in them. Brit patches, burn patches. Conformal, which we've been over. Insulin pill, we don't really see that much because I don't even know if diabetes kind of things enable on our server. I've never seen it. If you're getting like that, they're doing like a sugar overdose, give them one of these. Let's see. Ultiver, Cerniver, Cerniver. Epi, morphine. Morphine is good if they insist on being put under, but you need to like work on their mouth. That'll put them to sleep for a little bit so you can actually work on them. Also pretty good as a ad hoc tranquilizer for people that are being rowdy. You need to get out. Chloral is better for it. Chloral hydrate is better for it, but it's a little finicky to make. Takes a while, and you know, people might ask questions about your blue juice, so. You still have anti-radiation bottle. Pretty sure that's just a bunch of potassium iodide in there. I barely ever use it. Saline glucose. If you don't have any blood left, or you just need to get somebody up in a hurry, just give them saline glucose. That'll help with their blood loss. Toxin bottle seems a little counterintuitive until you realize that jelly people heal from toxin damage. They heal toxin damage from toxin damage. So you give them something poisonous and it heals their toxin damage. If you give them, you know, multiver, it does toxin damage to them. So you got some slime person coming in and they have toxin damage, give them this, have them drink it, they'll be fine. Spacicillin, that's good for if there is a disease going around and you don't want to catch it because you're treating it, give them a jam yourself full of it. Give it to other people that might be working around there, just to limit the spread. The gels are the same thing as the patches, except they have more uses in them. I usually grab those because it's more bang for your buck. Sterilizer gel, that'll make you do surgery a bit faster. Now, these ones you want to remember. Psychedene pills, these are for people that have phobias. And then medical gel, Synflesh, you want to usually reserve these. Synflesh is a good burn and brute med. It's a combination one, but it also deals toxin damage to the person if they're above a certain health threshold, so very limited use. But the biggest use you'll have is some miner will get dragged in and they'll be husked. You'll look at them, it'll say that they've been burnt to a grotesque husk. You can't revive them in that state. You can heal all their damage, but they will still be just this gray blob person, and it won't let you revive them. You need to apply Synflesh to them. I believe you can do 2 patches of 40 units, and it'll work. Or you can just buy both of these, put them into a beaker, and splash it onto them. They have to have their clothes off, like all their clothes off, for it to work. And that'll bring them back from being burned. For changelings, that doesn't work. Good indicator is you spend all this time making Synflesh and you splash on a person and they don't unhusk. That usually means you have a changeling. Full body replacements are not within the scope of this video. I might have to make a different one for that. Chemistry. Hope you have a chemist that knows how to do the factorial stuff, because I sure don't know how to do it. You can make a bunch of other chemicals on here. You can make chemical grenades over there. Yeah, it's all stuff you want to read up on. Those are the biggest basics here that I can think of, so hopefully this has been useful. If you ever have any questions, I'm basically always here in medical, so you can just ask me, or anybody else. Just use local OOC or normal OOC, or just ask in game in a non-immersion breaking away as best you can, I guess. Local immersion is best. So, yeah. That's, we get to practice. Yeah. This is another thing you'll have to deal with as a doctor, is that people will take the initiative and treat themselves. Especially if you know what they're doing. So you always want to check what chemicals they've given themselves so you don't overdose them. Okay. And voila! They have stopped glowing. They are no longer irradiated. Burns. Let's do a little bit of that. Voila. All better. Besides the 5 root damage to their chest. But, you know, who cares? Boom. Done. Victory spin. Yep, that's space station. Anyway, that's it. Have fun.